We started the circle a few years before Adam finished school when we met somebody who could help us along the way at a family advocacy event. We'd been to hear about a little bit about circles at various seminars, and we thought it would be a good idea to get some people together to help us plan for Adam's finishing school and move to adult life and what would he be doing. So that's when we started. It would have been great to start earlier, but that's when we started. It's a planning, really a forum where people can come together and talk about Adam's life and what Adam likes to do and he doesn't do, and helping him set things up for his future and helping his family. When Adam's parents and our generation sort of move on, Adam now has these friends of the children of the friends and people who are in the circle who have seen this happening and can participate in it. And it's for Adam's future, really, for the connections that he's making for his future.
The circle of support for me made me realise that Adam's part of a community, as all people are, and therefore it makes you aware that his life's needs are going to be looked after by a much bigger group of people, so that it's not just about Karen and
Ivan. His immediate family.
Yeah. I feel it's really, you know, contributed greatly to my life as well as the quality of Adam's life, because I had been part of Adam's life since he was born, and being a close friend of Karen's, had been perhaps a passive, a light person in his life, but I wasn't able to contribute constructively, and I wanted to be able to do that. So the circle has, you know, meant a lot to me, because it's enabled me to contribute in a structured way, but to do something really positive for Adam and not just be an onlooker and a friend to him, but to do that in a way that formally helps. And it's brought me a lot of joy and pleasure as well, because I'm able to be part of his life. Well, when it started, and as Karen just said, it's really evolved, it was to contribute ideas, to help. And I suppose I had never thought in the future too far about what Adam was capable of. And looking back, it's remarkable, really, because at that time I only saw Adam in that present moment as what he was able to do. So by being part of a group and brainstorming, it meant that we could come up with all these fantastic concepts that were really, possible. And so it opened my eyes to what could be done. So it was started as just an informal chat together in Karen's lounge room, Karen and Ivan's lounge room, as to what we could do. And it also then evolved to, okay, we need to meet again, and we would do so in this informal way. It gave us structure, because just like one would do in any long-term project, when you make a five-year plan in your life and you sit down, you want to write down goals and outcomes and then the actions to which you need. It just meant that we could structure it that way, but do it in small bite-sized chunks that enabled us just to focus on a small step at a time. And over a long period of time, we've achieved huge things. Yeah. So that's the key. And so if I may add, though, for a busy person, you know, you think, what would that mean? But it's actually better for a busy person, because it enables us to all know exactly when we're going to meet and what we need to think about prior to then. And by compartmentalising it like that, it's not overly too big a project for one person to contribute. It becomes really a pleasure and easy to do so. Yeah.
Well, when the circle first started, before Adam finished school, we really talked quite a bit about what sort of roles he would like to have after school. And we very much were not keen on the going to the group program type of route. So quite a lot of thinking about the vision and Adam's future was done at that time, and lots of documentation. And then a few directions were tried along the way. This is like the seventh or eighth year of the circle. So a lot of things have happened and been tried, and some were successful, some not. Well, finding people to be in the circle, we were very fortunate because we have quite a large family and some friends, good friends like Tracey. But we have one of our excellent, wonderful circle members is a person who used to work with Adam, who was one of Adam's supporters in the past, who still wanted to be involved in his life. So she came along and joined the circle. And along the way, Adam has met some people through his volunteering, through work, through just networking with other friends of the supporters. Some of the support workers have introduced Adam to their friends. And there is, if you look and think about it, there are possible circle members out there. You just have to be creative and ask them and try and make them feel welcome, because people actually do like, as Tracey said, people do like to contribute and people do like to have a way that they can have a bit of an impact on Adam's life, and this is a way that you can do it. A couple of Adam's younger cousins who have grown old enough have joined the circle, and a couple of the older ones have moved on to go on overseas trips and various things that young people do. And we've also brought in over the time Adam's the team leader of Adam's support worker team, so they have been able to come along and give feedback about what's been happening with Adam during his week, doing all the things that the circle has come up with as ideas, and also then take the ideas from the circle back to the team. And when we've broken up into these smaller groups, looking at all the specifics for Adam moving out, particularly the housemate group, the young people who are Adam's supporters have been part of that group because they are experiencing similar group living situations, shared houses and that type of thing. So this, the paid support team have more recently been quite involved in the circle rather than just Adam's family and friends for this specific purpose of moving out. We ran for quite a while with my brother Tony facilitating he pretty much runs, does the invitations, sends out the minutes, does all the organisational stuff, and he was running the meetings for a while. And more recently, when we've had these smaller subgroups, we've had another independent facilitator, who is Tammy, who has helped us run the smaller subgroups. Mm-hmm. So it is helpful if there's specific purpose to have somebody who is really good at structuring and helping the process happen. Yes, because as you can hear, we can just keep on talking.
Well, when we first started, we would nominate to get together every 6 to 8 weeks, and we'd make it a Sunday night, which sort of worked for most people, casual arrangement. And as Karen has mentioned, the circle numbers grew from interested people. For some people considering something like this, they might wonder, you know, what sort of commitment do I need to have? But it can be so flexible. There's been people that have come and gone, as Karen has mentioned, because of different, you know, commitments they've had to, and that's been fine, because if it goes over a long period of time, then it's as you can. But we also came up with the idea of making a roster of people to have quality time with Adam one-on-one to form that personal relationship with him, because he was used to having family and friends come and go in the house and attend family events, but that wasn't one-on-one time with him. And as every individual has relationships in their life, so did Adam need adult relationships, because once he left school, school formed that large structure for him of his other relationships, and then once school finished, it suddenly dissipated into a bit of a void. So this way, it actually worked out wonderfully, because with everyone putting together like a roster of when they could share time with Adam, it meant that actually happened, as opposed to the best intentions that people have to say, I'm going to pop in and come and see Adam with you. It was really helpful.
So with that weekend schedule, I'll just add to that. It's about once every 6 weeks, each person from the circle has a time when they go out with Adam, go for a drive, go for a walk, go to an outdoor music event, whatever's on at the time. That happens probably once every 6 weeks. He definitely comes down and says hello to everyone, which he's quite excited when everybody comes over, and he does realise that, I'm sure he realises that they're meeting about him. He's not particularly keen to sit for long periods of time listening to conversations, so he'll often say hello and go back to his whatever he's doing. But he'll come and go to the meetings. And we try to, I mean, we obviously know, that's one of the things about the circle, that people get to know Adam better as they spend time with him and as they have these, we have these discussions together. So we can really, we feel that we can really represent Adam's opinion and desires for things. Even though often we can't ask him, would you like to do this? And he'll say yes or no. If we try something in Adam, he clearly doesn't like it, or he'll make it obvious that this is something he doesn't want to carry on with, then we obviously respect that and move on to the next thing. Prior to the moving out, there were lots of times when we discussed jobs that Adam might do. So everybody had ideas of things like shelf stacking, which ended up to be now a job at Mitre 10. Adam works at Mitre 10 once a week, doing lots of different things. When we were talking about deliveries, Adam's tried lots of different deliveries over time, newspaper deliveries, leaflets, fruit and vegetables, which he does now. These were all ideas that came, much of it came from the circle discussing what Adam likes to do. And yeah, somebody knew, had a friend who had a fruit and vegetable delivery business, so it sort of went from that. So yeah, there have been a few those sort of specific achievements of the circle. A couple of years ago we started this plan. We were fortunate enough to be successful with the Supported Living Fund application, so we thought now is the time. So we had a couple of large circle meetings with everybody came along, which were facilitated by somebody who helped us at that time. And really it was the plan, what was this going to be? What sort of house? How would it happen? Who would live with Adam? Who would need to help doing various things? What would Adam need any preparation? All of this stuff was discussed in the big circle with everybody. And everyone had some very good ideas, which were fully documented by Libby, who was helping us at the time. And then it came to the point where it was really quite a big job. So we split up into smaller groups, smaller subgroups of the circle, depending on people's interests. Some people were talking about the housemates and how to find housemates. Some people were talking about the actual house, the accommodation, where would it be, what sort of house would it be. There was a group talking about communication, how everybody would communicate with each other when Adam was living there. So this all happened over a long period of time. It's still happening now. And the groups meet as regularly as they can, and everything's documented, so the process has been quite quite detailed.
Informed, yeah.
And yeah, it has to be structured in that way.